I really hope my ancestors hurt this man, because how dare he lie to me? What up, what up, what up, everybody? I am the Mademoiselle, and this is my channel. And today, we're gonna be doing a story time. And today's story time is gonna be about something that's been weighing very, very heavy on my chest, okay? So a couple of weeks ago, probably a month or so ago, I said that I was apartment shopping. Now you guys already know if you've been here, and I hit 200,000 subscribers, I did an empty condo tour. What the fuck? Oh, that's my boyfriend. I would know I did do a empty condo tour, and I was so happy. I was so happy. I got a bigger space. I got an office space. I was chilling. I had my life set, and then some caca happened. And today, we're gonna talk about that caca today, because this has been weighing heavy on my heart. And I realized things really only get released from me for real, when I make it a YouTube video. I got my wine, okay? This is Red Moscato, alright, Bancanora. And I got my Twizzlers. This is my favorite candy ever. Before we get into all of this, people always ask me like, oh my God, like, can we send you stuff? Oh my God, what's your PO box? And I'm like, it's always in my description box and it's always in my pinned comment. So if you ever want to send me anything, like a drawing, I don't know. Get your wine, get your snacks, get your lice, get your fried chicken, get whatever you need, because Jodi, I'm about to do it. This is about to be 30 minutes. About, I bet. So once upon a time, not long ago, I moved into this condo, okay? I moved October 1st. I really wanted to move for the simple fact that I wanted an office space. It's very, very difficult for me to work in my bed because I fall asleep, I get distracted, and it's just, it's not an ideal situation. And plus, I wanted a bigger space to film and just throw my extra shit that I don't need. It's like, no. I get a lot of sponsored stuff, especially when it comes to hair and clothes, and I wanted like a separate closet specifically for sponsored stuff, specifically for my wigs or whatever, right? So I really wanted to find a bigger space. So I found this condo on Craigslist. Craigslist is lit, okay? For those of you who are looking for apartments, look on Craigslist. I mean, you may come across like a crazy axe murder or something like that, but I'm sure you'll be fine. I mean, I didn't die yet, right? I was always residing in Elizabeth. I moved to Newark for my other apartment. I decided to still stay in Newark, and I'm gonna move again, and I'm gonna stay in Newark again. But we're gonna get to that later. So everything was easy breezy, okay? The guy was cool, but I knew something was a little off with him, okay? I came here to look at this apartment. This was one of the first apartments I looked at. I looked at it maybe like mid-September. And when I looked at it, the guy was currently painting. You know, my landlord was painting. He was doing all types of stuff, like renovations had to be done since the last tenants moved out. And I asked him specifically, keep this in mind, what happened to the last tenants? You know, we had to evict them, And when that had happened, you know, apparently in the process of being petty, they broke my the master bedroom door. So I had like a broken master bedroom door, and it was just annoying because that door didn't get fixed till probably like January, December. I think December, I'm gonna say December. So for 2 months, I didn't have like a working door, and they took the door off thinking that they were gonna get the door, but the door didn't come until December after I moved in. So I told him I would get back to him because I was still looking at other places. All the other places fell through. One place was taking way too long to answer. I was like, you know what, let me contact this guy. So I think it was about like a week and a half later, I contacted him like, hey, is the apartment still available? He was like, yeah. So boom, put down the deposit, signed the lease, and he was like, oh yeah, so about your parking spot, the garage door is broken, therefore there's only one entrance, and they're using my parking spot for the, you know, drive-through way. Because the way the building garage is set up, there's two doors. One is completely broken, and the other one is what people are using. There's a back one that everyone's using to come in. Now, this was a completely believable response. I had absolutely no reason to question this, so I didn't question it. Like, I really didn't, because it made sense. I was more annoyed about this door, because it was just like, I'm one of those people, I have anxiety. Everybody who knows me, who's been here, knows I have anxiety. And one of the things that really causes me anxiety is open doors. Constant open doors really stresses me out and causes me anxiety. If my closet door is open and I can see it, it bothers me. If my bathroom door is open and I can see it, it bothers me. If my room door, like if I'm in my office, even if I'm not filming, I have to close the door. Like, I'm just really big on closed doors. So the fact that I couldn't have a closed door was really annoying. So like, I told them like, hey, before I moved in, I was like, can you put the door back on? And then like, I would put like an ottoman in front of it to close it. because there was nothing I could really do. And also, I don't allow Sage to sleep with me, and I didn't have time for her to be like running up and down my room when I'm asleep. So I was like, you know what? I need to just put it back on. I'll wait till the door comes. I'm not about to live here with no door. Like, that's ghetto. Put the door on and be like, okay, the door's coming. Took forever to get the fucking door. I was living here with a broken door. It just looked ghetto, but you know, it wasn't a big deal. Then all of a sudden the toilet started getting clogged out of nowhere. My mailbox door key wasn't like, the thing broke. Like it fell off. Like I put the damn key in there and I turned it and it the key went with the motherfucking lock. I was just like, what going on? Like, what's going on? So it was just an array of little stuff, but it wasn't unlivable. I was trying to be optimistic, okay? So the mailbox thing got fixed, the door got fixed, the toilet got fixed. I was like, you know what? Easy peasy, lemon squeezy. The weird thing about this building is like, people have always been looking at me kind of funny or like avoiding me. And I couldn't understand it. I could not understand why. I thought people were just hotep over here. They were bougie. I never thought of anything about it because I barely see anyone anyway. But anytime I would see people, they would do real fucked up shit to me. Like, they would see me come to the door and let the door shut on me. Like, it was just like, do you want to fight? Do you want to be turned into a dog? Like, what do you want? Because whatever you looking for, I can give it to you. See, the only issue is the parking. I'm waiting for the gate to be fixed. Now, the thing is with the parking, that was a really, really big thing for me. And I would have never took this apartment if it wasn't for the goddamn parking. Okay? For the simple fact that I travel. Y'all know I be out. Okay? I be living my best life. Therefore, I can't just leave in my car out in the Newark streets because one, street cleaning. So it was just like annoying that, you know, I couldn't get my parking spot for the simple fact that the gate wasn't fixed. So I was like, you know what? I'm going to calm down about this. I'm going to look past it. Then after my housewarming, okay, you guys know I had a housewarming. I need a Twizzler for this. I come outside the day after to go to dance practice. And my car is vandalized. On the passenger side, not even the driver's side. I'm thinking, okay, maybe someone sideswiped me, but I'm like, wait, I'm on the right side of the street. My bumper on my passenger side, it looked like somebody took a crowbar to my shit and fucked it up, and someone dented my hood. Now, I know a lot of you are probably thinking, oh, somebody probably don't like you and da-da-da. Nobody knows where I live. The only people who know where I live are the people that came to my housewarming, and I knew every single one of those people. I know where they live. I got their phone numbers. There was no strangers at my house. Nobody's ever followed me home. I don't invite people here. No one knows I live here. It's a very low-key part of Newark. You're not gonna find this building. So I'm just like, what the fuck? I was livid. So I contacted my landlord and I said, someone vandalized my car. Like, bro, like, can you do something about this? Because like, what the hell? Like, have you checked on this parking? He's like,
I've been parking on there for years on the street and nothing has ever happened to my car.
Did I ask you about your car? Did I ask you about your car? I don't care about your car. My car was just vandalized. I don't care. I don't care. I don't caca, monsieur. I'm like, why is he telling me about his life? I don't care. Now at this point, that's when I realized something's wrong here. Now, if you guys don't know, you guys haven't guessed already, my landlord has actually lived here before. He's lived here before and he moved because he had kids and, you know, they couldn't live here anymore because it was too small. So he went and bought a house. Okay? So the fact that he said he's always been parking on the street, that either means the gate was always broken or something else. Inspector Ivana on a motherfucking case. So, eventually, it comes to a point where I realize PSENG, which is the electricity and the gas servicer for Newark, kept contacting me saying that they couldn't get a meter read to my meter. So I was getting estimated bills. Now, these estimated bills weren't so bad at first. My first bill was like maybe $30, and it was like $50, then it was like $100, then it was like $150, and it's like, Pacasa, what? Where are you getting these estimations? Because I'm never in my house. I'm never freaking here. And when I'm here, I barely even turn on the light. The only time this light is ever open is when I'm filming. Most of the time, I just have these little fairy lights on. Unless Sage is fucking with the lights when I'm going. Is the cat messing with the lights? Why am I paying $150 for electricity for one person who ain't never here? Right? Or PSENG. And they're like, yeah, we can't get a meter read on your meter. Ta-ta-ta. And I'm like, but there's other condos in this building. So you're telling me everyone in this building is getting a estimated meter read. That doesn't sound accurate. So again, I'm trying to figure out why they can't access the meter, but personally, I didn't think anything of it for the simple fact that, like, that's just weird and I don't know much about condos, okay? Now, the thing is with condos are like mini houses for the most part. It's not like your standard apartment building. They're in a building, but everything is very independent. You have your own electric panel, you have your own, you got your own HVAC unit. Everything is like a really, really small house. So realistically, I was just like, okay, this is very interesting that you can't access mine, but you can access everyone else's, because everyone's meter, at least, is in one area. Everybody's HVAC and, you know, all those other systems are next to their thing. But as far as the electric stuff, you know, for PSE&G to read the meters, that's in one central location. So I'm like, it's very, very interesting, you know, but I didn't think to look in it. Okay, I had no reason to believe that it wasn't true. I did think it was weird, but I was like, whatever, I don't know what to do about it. And then, you know, I contacted my landlord. I told him what was going on. He was like, oh, okay, that's weird. When do they do it? And I'm like, okay, these things are like previously scheduled. Like they're scheduled for like the 13th and 14th of each month. Like it's different days, but it's specifically a specific week that they do it. And it's already preset for the year. So they give you a schedule when they're gonna read your meter. And I have seen PSE&G outside my apartment numerous times, like coming in and reading meters. So I thought specifically, is it that y'all can't access the door? Because that's a very hard door to get through, because there's not many people coming in and out of this building, and it's very difficult to get someone to open that door. So I'm thinking, okay, maybe, but that's weird. I'm like, they have to have a key. So boom, one day I get a text message, right? And it's from my landlord, they know my man. And it was like maybe like 10 o'clock at night. And I get this text about some, hey, do you have the heat on? And I believe it was off. And he was like, oh, okay, can you turn it on for a second? They're trying to say that your HVAC unit is leaking all the way from up there down to the garage. Now, I'm just like, that doesn't even make any sense. I'm all the way on the fourth floor, third, second, primary floor, garage, where? Oh, whatever, turned it on, you know. Throughout the night, he was telling me to turn it off, to see if the leaking was really from the HVAC unit. Don't know what that came about, but he sent PSE&G there probably the next day or whatever. The next day, maybe a day or two later. Open the door to PSE&G, and the guy's like,
damn, like, you know, we're always coming here for, where you live at again?
And he says my apartment number. I was like, yeah. He's like,
yeah, this is like, what, third or fourth time we're coming here for your HVAC unit?
I said, well, I just moved here. I don't know nothing about y'all coming here 3 to 4 or 5 times, whatever the case may be, because I just moved here, sir. I don't know. And he's like, yeah,
we always coming here for this one unit. Like, I don't know what's going on.
When we're coming back up, we stop on the second floor for some odd reason, and this guy gets in the elevator. And I'm just looking at him like, we're going up. He's like, oh,
yeah, I'm going up too.
I'm like, for what? He's like, oh,
I'm here to see what's going on with the HVAC as well. I'm like,
is that right? It's the four of us now. So it's two PSE&G guys. It's the guy that came in the elevator to talk about some media for PSE&G, and then it's me. And this is early in the morning. It's like 9-10 o'clock in the morning. And you know, they go to the HVAC. Now, mind you, just a little tidbit here. My landlord came to open up this HVAC door so that PSE&G could come in, because absolutely no one else has the key for that. The only people that have the key for the HVAC, whether they rent it out or not, is the owner of that unit. So he came to open it. Mind you, he lives all the way like Long Island, like not Manhattan, New York, but like upstate New York type. Has his wife, fiance, whatever, drive him all the way over here just open the door. Would have been easier to just give me the key, but I mean, I understand for security reasons, but you won't believe the caca. PSE&G opens it and they're looking and they're like, damn, we can barely like really look because
your door is bolted.
I said, what do you mean? He was like,
the HVAC door is like bolted shut, like no one can get through.
So now the guy starts talking, like he starts inserting himself, and he's like,
yeah, you know, we told him about this HVAC leak a long time ago, and now he's bolted the door so no one can get through, and we don't understand what's going on. Like, he keeps saying he fixed it, but clearly he didn't fix it because we're still having issues.
So he starts going in about how basically this HVAC has been giving problems for a very, very long time, and my landlord was supposed to fix it a very, very long time ago, but he absolutely never took the initiative to fix it. He said he fixed it, but instead of fixing it, he just bolted the door so no one can look at it ever again. this is a little interesting. It sounds a bit strange. But I still wasn't convinced because I'm like, how is my HVAC leaking all the way from the fourth floor to the third floor to the second floor to the garage?
So he's like, oh, okay, well, like, just to give you a little perspective, I earned the second floor unit. And because your HVAC is leaking, I can't rent out my second unit, and my previous tenant moved out for the simple fact that he doesn't have any heat or hot water because your leaking HVAC damaged his.
At this point, I'm like, there's no way. I was like, there's no way. I went, I looked, and it was true. He showed me, and I was just like, bruh, the whole entire closet is disgusting. It smells like mold. The walls are fucking like deteriorating. And you can obviously tell that the HVAC in that closet is not working. Then you go to the people directly under me on the third floor. They're so nice. I like them. They're probably the only people that actually acknowledge my presence with these other people at the normal floor. Everyone else, like, every time they see me, they got an attitude and it's like, listen, like, y'all can square the fuck up. But anyhow, the third floor, luckily they still have heat. They still have hot water. But their guest bathroom, their whole wall, kid you not, is made up of duct tape. Made up of duct tape. I wish I would have took a picture of that. It's duct tape. Like, to the point where you think, I thought it was painted blue, but then I realized, oh my God, that's duct tape. Because it's deteriorating from my HVAC leaking downstairs. Because the HVAC unit is directly behind the guest bathroom. And it's been leaking so bad that it's like their whole bathroom has been leaking. And it's been seeping into the walls. So their whole bathroom smells like mold. Their whole HVAC closet, whatever, smells like mold. Like, even when you go on like the third floor, like say if I turn on my heat all night, which I never really do, but one time I did, and I think it was that night before because they were testing it still, you can smell it as soon as you get into the hallway. You smell the mold. Now I'm just sitting here like, yo, like, and I seen all of this shit. And that's when, you know, I came back up, like after he sent me all of this, we came back up to PSCG because they're still looking because they had to unbolt the damn door. And they're like, yeah, there's definitely water in the HVAC. There's water just sitting like on the bottom of the HVAC. And they're like, you know, this can cause a fire. This is a very serious issue. And the guy that showed me around or whatever, he's just like, yeah.
Like, honestly though, like, we've been telling him this, he doesn't believe it. He doesn't want to listen to us. He keeps thinking it's a lie. We don't know what to do anymore. Can you please take pictures? Can you record? Can you call him yourself?
Like, we had to have PSENG call him because he was so fucking animate. There was nothing wrong with his HVAC. All of a sudden, he's like,
yeah, like, he's always having a problem. We've had our fair share of issues, and I have absolutely no idea what to do about it. At this point, I'm just like, you know what? I don't want nothing to do with it, but I just want him to see that there's absolutely something wrong with his HVAC unit so he can fix it. We've had court orders on the building, and people have been sued or whatever. I've been called a slumlord because, like, of the situation, and I don't know what to do about it because he won't listen about his HVAC having a problem.
And he goes, see, now this man had diarrhea of the mouth. And this is what really pissed me off. He said,
I mean, like, haven't you ever wondered why you don't have parking?
Tell me more, little snitch. Tell me more.
Oh, well, I mean, he's never paid his association dues.
If you don't know, when you're part of a condo, when you own a condo, you have to pay dues to the association that the condo is, you know, in or owned by. And I'm just sitting there like, what? He's like, yeah.
He hasn't paid his dues, so he doesn't have access to parking. And if you try to park your car there, you're going to be towed. Yeah, like, what did he tell you?
I'm like, he told me I can't park there because my parking spot is being used as a drive-thru because the other gate is broken. He was like,
bullshit. He just didn't pay his association dues. I mean, I heard you're getting estimated bills as well, right?
I'm like, yeah, I was trying to get to the bottom of that. He's like,
oh, he doesn't have access to meters. I mean, your landlord's been lying to you. Clearly he's lying. I don't understand why he's like this. I really don't.
I was so angry. This man done fucking lied to fucking me, bro. He lied. He bullface lied. And it's like, I'm paying a lot of, bro, my rent is high. For me not to have a parking spot, for me to be paying estimated bills, and for you to be lying to me. I should have called my family in Haiti and had this man turned into a goat, because how dare you lie to me?
Yeah, I mean, that's why the last tenants left.
I was like, oh, okay, well, he told me that they left because he had to get them evicted because they weren't paying rent. He was like,
he weren't paying rent because he refused to fix the things in the apartment.
Wow. Ask tenants moved out specifically because of that and of other reasons, because he wouldn't fix the toilet. Remember when I said the toilet has issues and a whole array of other issues that he refused to fix while they were living in the unit. Now, at this point, I was like,
I see you all the time around the building, and I want to talk to you to make sure you know, or ask if you do know, because, you know, I want to introduce myself to you, but, like, I couldn't for the simple fact that, like, I don't know if you know, I don't know if you don't know, and I don't want to be in a spot to tell you all these things, and then, you know, we end up having more issues, because I've had issues with your landlord in the past, and, you know, like, we even have a group chat, and we're always talking about this, and that's why you're not in the group chat, because, I mean, like, we don't want anyone to pounce on you.
Words can't explain the amount of shocked that I was absolutely shocked, shook, confused. I was like, so, like, I was in awe, I was in amazement. I was just like, I can't believe all the bullshit that I'm hearing right now. Like, I just can't believe it. So the last tenants were evicted, but apparently they left before they were actually evicted for the simple fact that he wouldn't fix shit. And then he didn't pay his association bills. That's why I'm paying all of this money for absolutely no reason. Ladies and gentlemen, I've been played. I don't like being played. I don't like being fooled, but I'm also not a snitch. Now, the thing is, 9 times out of 10, when I talk shit about somebody, I don't give a shit if they go back and run and tell the person to say that I said it. But, you know, a lot of people are very, very, you know, on the low and don't like confrontation or whatever. And he was like, yeah, don't tell him I told you any of this, that. So I was like, I bet. So I hit my landlord up again and I was like, listen, you need to fix this parking issue. You need to fix this electricity issue, because at this point, I'm not dealing with it no more. Like, you're doing too much. I'm getting annoyed. You're pissing me off. Like, I went in on him, but in a very respectful way. And he was just like, I mean, I don't have a problem with you breaking the lease. That's what it was a longer conversation than that, but he was like, oh, I don't have a problem with you breaking the lease. I'm just like, oh, I can break the lease? Bye. So that's when you guys saw the entire post of me on Instagram talking to me, yeah, apartment hunting, that. And that's the whole story for now. Because I am aiming to move April 1st or May 1st. I'm not trying to stay here through the summer at all. Like, I love this apartment so much. And if he would just fucking fix the parking issue and fix the issue with the meters, I wouldn't have a problem staying. I genuinely would not. Like, I really like this apartment. I like where I'm at. I'm very, very comfortable. I'm very, very settled. But I'm not about to be sitting here paying all this money for a nigga to fucking sit here and lie to me. It's more so the principle of the fact that he's lying to me and thinking that I'm dumb. Leave him poo dumb. I don't like when people lie to me. I don't like when people think I'm stupid. I don't like when I'm paying a liar. So I just want to get the fuck out of this motherfucker's face. I don't want nothing to do with him. And I know damn well, as soon as I get my deposit back, I'm gonna rip this man a new one. I'm gonna be like, okay, and by the way, you should pay your association dues so shit like this doesn't happen again. And you should also be 100% truthful with the tenants, because that's just not okay. Mm-hmm. I feel bad for this man's fiance, because this man is just a fucking compulsive liar. Comment down below, have you had any ridiculous tenant situations or ridiculous landlord situations that you want to talk about? Let me know down in the comment section below. Do you have any crazy landlord or even tenant or even roommate situations that you've had to go through that you want to talk about? Because I love to read these stories, because I'm so annoyed and I was so stressed and I'm so happy I got all of this off my chest. Like, I talked to a few people, like a very select few people about this, and it's just like, it really, really annoys me that I have to go through this, because I really liked where I was at. And now I'm gonna have to move because this man is a fucking liar and I'm overpaying for living where I'm living. So at this point, yeah, if you know any popping ass apartments in Newark, hit a bitch up. Or even surrounding areas, you know, hit us just up. If you had a crazy situation like this, hit us just up. Part 2 coming soon, because I know this shit is not the end. Make sure you like, share, subscribe, do all that. And I'm gonna see y'all next time.